And a silver kind and rose gold, because I had decided to get the rose gold kind, and I believe gold also, but the rose gold is really popular. Enough of this rambling, and we're just gonna get started. And as you can see, I have like a bare face. When it comes to the packaging, they look like this. And I'm just gonna take all these off because like there's no point of me keeping the plastic on. But one thing I can say is that on the back of this, it has like the usage tips and how to clean your makeup brushes and how to store your makeup brushes. And yeah, normalized maintenance brush, brush gently on a clean piece of tissue to get rid of the residual makeup. Clean the brush once a week if regularly used. And like the quality of them is like really soft. And I also do want to show you guys that some of the hair on the bristles are like sticking up. And like most likely I'm just gonna cut it off. Like you get what you pay for, you know, it is $9. And I do really like, even though like they're synthetic, like it has like a real hair type of feel to it. But yeah, that's one thing that irritates me, like these little hairs that are sticking up. Then next, for the smaller brushes, this is what they look like. So there's this one right here, this one. Mainly these are for like eyeshadows. Oh yeah, this one's an eyeliner brush for sure. And this one, and just the rest of these, you know. And I think you can use this one as a concealer brush. I might do that. You can use this one to brush out your eyebrows. It's a highlighting brush. So I can just highlight my all-time favorite foundation I'm gonna go in with. And it's the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation. And I am in the shade 228 Soft Tan. Let's see how this works. Ooh. Hold up. Hold up, wait a minute. As you can see, it's not leaving any streak marks. And that's one thing I cannot stand when it comes to brushes. But this is not leaving any streak marks. So hold up. Do y'all see that? Ooh, okay. Oh, I'm liking how this is blending. Cause y'all know I always use a sponge. I don't really use brushes like that when it comes to blending out my foundation. Ooh, hold up. This might be a little steel. Oh my gosh. And I still got some foundation on the back of my hand. So I'm just gonna do that and put it on this side. Need more coverage on this side. Y'all, it's blending it so well. Like, I'm very, very surprised. Next, for the contouring, I am gonna go in with this brush right here. And it is different from this brush. This one's more of like a puppy look, and this one's more of an angled look. I just really wanted this one so I can get into the crevices of like my face and stuff. But yeah, I'm gonna go in with this and just blend out my contour. Actually, no, I changed my mind, because with this one right here, this is different from the foundation one. But this one has an angle as well, and I really wanna use this to like sculpt my face and make sure that, you know, it gets sculpted. And with the other one, it's like too round. It might give me like a round type of look. But with this one, it will give me like a sharp contour look. You guys will see. Okay, so now finally with the powders, I'm gonna go on with this brush right here, this tapered angled, what was it called? I honestly forgot the name. Oh yeah, I'm gonna bake. I prefer baking anyway. So I'm just gonna like do it like a pat type of blend out. Not like fully do this the whole time, but like pat, then like do that. Then I'm gonna go in with this brush right here and just like add bronzer to my nose contour. And I'm gonna use the same brush and just add bronzer to my eyelid just to get some color, you know.